Hey everybody, it's Tom Barnes for the Chicago scene at the Greater Chicago Food Depository. Because we are still knee-deep in this pandemic, vaccines are rolling out, but nonetheless, people still need to eat, they still need food, and this organization has set up grants to several food pantries around the city to help set up with nutritional facts, to set up job placement, and even learn how to cook. So I'm gonna talk to Nicole here and see exactly what they're doing and how they're doing it through basically all volunteers. It's incredible work here at the Greater Chicago Food Depository for the Chicago scene. Let's say hi. All right, I've made my way down here to Nicole, who's helped leading the charge of the Greater Chicago Food Depository. Good morning, how are you?
Good, I'm great, good to see you.
Thank you for letting me come in and just walk around the space. This is an incredible space that you guys have here. I mean, it's not, I think for people who have never volunteered or who have never been here before, I mean, it is something to see. It's a well-oiled machine. Well done.
It is. We have over 225 employees who come in this building every day. We have hundreds of volunteers who come. And now that we're still in the midst of this pandemic, we've needed them more than ever. It's not as busy as you might see it in a pre-pandemic world, because we need to social distance and be safe, but this is where it all happens in terms of where food comes. But we work with over 700 programs and partners in the community, and every day volunteers are on the front lines in every neighborhood making sure that families get connected to food, nutrition benefits like SNAP, and to work. And as you know more than anyone, food has been just a key theme in the pandemic, with unemployment, whole industries challenged, neighborhoods have just really needed to get connected to food.
Yeah, and I mean, one of the outstanding things that you guys have to offer are grants for different food pantries around the area. Talk about that, because that's something that was, I don't want to say unexpected, but a very pleasant surprise. During the pandemic, you know, donations have stepped up where it has allowed you guys to provide grants, right?
Absolutely. And what the pandemic has told us, we've learned so much from the pandemic, and we've learned that the food system was fragile, not just the emergency food system.
And maybe outdated, right?
And a little outdated. Uh-huh. And what most people don't know is most of our partners who operate food pantries are smaller, faith-based grassroots organizations. They're primarily volunteer-led, so they don't have a lot of staff. They have really small operating budgets, and they have been the heroes during the pandemic. So for the Food Depository, our number one priority has been to keep them open and operational, making sure they have food, awarding them operating grants so that they can buy PPE, cleaning supplies, everything that we've all had to do differently in this new normal, that costs money. So we wanted to make sure we invested in them, to surprise their volunteers with lunch or other stipends to help keep that work going. But we also knew that there were neighborhoods where there were gaps, where there were not enough pantries. And we want pantries to be not a place of shame, because no one wants to go to a pantry, mm-hmm. right? But we want people to feel joy and delight when they come into a pantry. They want them to feel like it's their pantry in their community. And the best way we knew to do that was to create an opportunity where we can invite faith and community-based organizations to tell us what they wanted their pantry to look like, where they wanted to be, how they wanted it to come to life. And we awarded four organizations just that opportunity. They received $200,000, and these pantries, again, are designed by the community for the community.
So it's not an organization telling the community what they want, it's the community telling the organization what they want, which sounds like a simple idea, but it doesn't happen quite often that way.
It doesn't. A lot of time what happens is, a lot of us are all well-meaning, and we care, and mm-hmm. we want to volunteer, and we want to support communities, but we often come in and say, we know what you need best.
Right.
And we flip that
on. Like the corporate America vibe of like how things are done, which is like, but you don't know what it's like here, right?
Exactly. We flipped it on its head, and we went to partners, and some of them were actually surprised. And we said, tell us what you want. What is your vision? What does a pantry look like? And I so love how it's coming together. We have a partner, New Life in North Lawndale, and they are turning an old corner store into a vibrant pantry. They're commissioning a Latina artist to create a mural on the side of the pantry. Community members will be involved in deciding what should the paint on the wall be, and what should the mural look like? And that's real community ownership.
Right.
So when a family comes in the pantry, they'll say, this is my pantry.
Yeah, it's almost like a community center hub almost, you know, where they might have nutritional classes or even cooking programs to just help people in job employment services, just to become this one hub for people to stop in and be proud of.
Absolutely. You know, all food is free at the food depository, so there'll be dairy items, meat, protein, fruits and vegetables will be there. We love this program called SNAP, where families can get a card where they can go into a grocery store and buy even more food. And then we know that there's work opportunities. In some cases, pantries will use young people as a youth development effort to be volunteers in the pantry, so we love that. We have a partner on DeLeo in the Washington Heights Roseland area, which is another high need area. And there they have an architect who's donating their time to help design their new facility. So I think that's what I love. You know, that's the silver lining in the pandemic. I mean, we're all tired. I know our pantry leaders on the front lines are exhausted. But the silver lining is that everyone has mobilized around this. If people didn't know that we had communities across Chicago that had high rates of unemployment, inadequate food access, inequity in other ways, we all know it today.
Absolutely.
But the great thing is people are saying, now that I know, I want to help.
Yeah, so how do people help?
Part of this movement.
Yeah.
I would say, you know, one way is to reach out to chicagosfoodbank.org. Mm-hmm. There's ways to volunteer. There's ways to make contributions. There's ways to get involved in advocacy and policy, because a lot of how we sort of solve food insecurity and hunger is rooted in what the programs the government offers around federal nutrition programs. So we love for people to learn more about those efforts, but we're making connections. So when you connect with the food depository, part of, you know, what our role is to connect you with that neighborhood pantry. So if you wanna be at a food distribution and volunteer in your neighborhood, you can, but there's all sorts of things you can do, so.
Thank you very much for taking the time to speak to me. You guys have several volunteers going through right now and packaging things up, so I'm going to step out of the way so you guys can get back to the good work that you do. So thank you.
Thanks so much for coming out.
Yeah, no problem. Thank you. Well, there you have it. Great things happening here at the Greater Chicago Food Depository, TBARNAS at WGNTV.com. That's TBARNAS at WGNTV.com. If you have a suggestion for the Chicago scene. Until then, I'll see you later. Thanks for watching.